my way.
Where are you? What are you doing?
I'm coming home. I'm tired.
I don't know why you bother to come home.
It's no bother. I like to come home. I never know what I'm going to find.
If you look on the pad, you'll see that Burbank call again.
What did he say?
Nothing. I wanted to speak to you. Who is he anyway?
Business.
You think I don't know who Burbank is? He's a psychiatrist, isn't he?
You're drunk. Or you're crazy.
That's what you think. You've been talking to Burbank about me. Haven't you? You're trying to get rid of me.
You're paranoid.
Easy to see, isn't it?
You need help.
So I'm right. But don't lie to me, Jay. I can't bear men who lie to me.
Men? How many men have you got? I want to help you, but I would prefer to strangle you.
Go ahead.
Don't solve my problems, but solve your problems. And at a shrewd guess, a couple of other people's problems as well.
They put her in a sanatorium. If I were crazy, would you put me in a sanatorium?
Not unless you wanted me to.
If I were crazy, I wouldn't know what I wanted. But I do know what I want. I want you. Right from the first, that's what I wanted. You.
Thank you. There's someone I want you to meet. You don't mind if I steal him, do you?
No.
You're all right, Sandy.
Perfectly.
Excuse me.
Dreaming. You weren't here. There was a man and he had a gun.
What do you mean I wasn't here?
Oh, I don't know. I thought you'd gone. There was a man. The man was me.
Do you want a drink? Something's up. Why don't you tell me what it is?
Yes, I am sick of my life.
With me, you mean?
You know what I want to do? I want to give it up. I never want to smoke again. It is bad for you.
You're crazier than I am. I could never love a man who did not smoke.
I feel like a snake. I want to shed something. I need a second skin.
You need two things. You need to be truthful.
And
you need... You need me. One day I'll leave you, and then you'll understand.
I love you.
Loving me is not enough. You also have to care about me. Otherwise, I will go crazy. One day I'll leave you. Then you will understand.
been trying to call you on the phone. Have you been out?
No.
Why didn't you answer?
Why not sitting there, please?
What's the matter? Is it broken?
Do you mind if I, sit there? We were very pleased with the man on the boat. Did you see the newspapers?
Did I make the headlines?
Page 5.
I used to make the headlines.
Are you all right?
Something stupid has happened. My wife has left me. My wife. Celandine.
Why haven't you contacted the office? You haven't forgotten about the Shy, have you?
I can't take on the Shy. Not now. Can't.
A client specifically requested our best man.
I'm serious. Get someone else.
If you're that serious, you can return the advance.
I can't. I spent it.
What, 10 grand in 10 days?
In 10 minutes. And a diamond pin. For my wife.
And now your wife's run away.
Don't say that.
With the pin. You'd better find her. I'll call you tomorrow. I don't want to come here again.
If you had an affair, would you tell me about it?
No. I might. Might not.
If I took a lover, I would always tell you. Once it was over, I would have to. But only when it was over. That sounds awful, doesn't it?
Sounds suspicious.
Don't be silly. Do you think it's easier living together, I mean, now we're married? Or was it easier before?
I think it's easier now.
Why?
I feel more secure. You're my wife. I know I'm not going to lose you.
And you really have no idea where she could have gone?
No. Tell me the truth, Melanie. Was there another man?
There are always other men, Jay. You know that. There are always other men, and there are always other women.
Tell me.
I don't know. I really don't. After all, I'm not my sister's keeper.
Burbank. I can't answer that. I'll let you know. No, she hasn't come back yet.
I told you once before. You picked the wrong girl. The wrong sister. I don't think I'll ever forgive you for that.
For over a year, I loved you both. And then when she left me and married Edward, I loved only her. And when she came back, I loved you both again. And now that she is gone, I love only her.
Now that she's gone, it sounds as if you only love her when she's not there. The fact is, Jay, you liked having two sisters.
Going to the office today, Mallory?
Go away, Burbank.
I'd like to. I'd like to go away forever, but they're getting anxious.
I really wanted to talk about your wife.
Celandine? You knew her?
I met her once when I came to see you.
You knew her?
No, don't misunderstand. We just talked. I was very unhappy.
Like you are now. Why don't you stay home and talk to your own wife?
I can't talk to my wife. I hate her. You see, it all started with Chiva. Poor Chiva. He was one of the best men we ever had. Then he got clever. He found out who his shy was. And for another $10,000, he thought it worth his while to fake it. He and the shy made a deal, but I found out about it. It doesn't matter how, it's my job. So I made a phone call. Didn't take long. You can't fuck about with the office, you know that. Do you ever meet Chiva?
No, I know his name.
One of the best.
Like I said.
Not as good as you.
What are you talking about?
You were the last person to see him alive. You knew him as James.
I don't believe it.
Chiva, James, different name, same man. James was Chiva. I had to make the decision, and you weren't here. I made that call. I made it. Just a runner, Mallory, just a runner. You're the best.
You should not have told me about James.
I didn't know that you were going to be assigned to him. I didn't know.
Hello? I haven't decided yet.
You must make up your mind, Mallory. We understand that you're upset over the disappearance of your wife.
Burbank, tell you about my wife.
The shy must take place, Mallory. You have 24 hours to decide. Either repay the advance, or be at boarding gate 7, Air Canada, flight 102 to London, 12:15, Sunday.
Then what?
The car will be waiting for you. And you'll proceed to Froxfield, Suffolk, England.
Where will the shy take place?
Oh.
Harbor Advertising. One moment, please. I'll put you through.
Alder Burbank.
I'm sorry, Mr. Mallory. Mr. Burbank isn't here. Perhaps Mr. Jeffries can help. This is Mr. Mallory, Mr. Jeffries. Mr. Jeffries has taken over from Mr. Burbank for the time being.
What happened to Burbank?
Mr. Burbank hasn't been feeling too well.
It's all right when I saw him.
Have you made up your mind?
I'm not going through with this until I know where my wife is.
Oh, yes. Your wife's run off, hasn't she?
She hasn't run off. She's disappeared, that's all. Time's running out. Why don't you just get yourself another man?
Because the office wants you.
What's so special about this assignment? Why haven't I been told who the Shy is? What's in Foxfield? Why England? Why Sunday? Something wrong with this assignment, isn't there?
As far as I'm concerned, Murray, the only thing wrong with this assignment is you.
I haven't seen her for 5 years.
You saw her after we were married, then?
We had a son. You took him away from me. You needn't have done that.
I didn't take Dominic away from you. Celandine did. She was right.
And now she's walked out on you. Not surprised. No one man could hold Celandine. Yes, she obsesses us all, doesn't she? I heard she was seeing someone. About 2 years ago.
How did you hear?
Keep in touch.
2 years ago. Who was it?
I'm not sure I should tell you.
Who was it?
All right. His name was Deverell. I've got some cuttings.
Cuttings? Newspaper cuttings about this man and my wife?
No. Just about Deverell.
after all this?
This is my past. This is who I used to be.
Keep these.
No, I'd rather you didn't.
I'll keep them. I'll see their return to you.
We have something in common, though, don't we? The eyes. The hair. Face. The arms. A bit thin in the arms, though, don't you think? The breasts. It must have changed a bit by now.
Hello. No, I'll let you know when I'm ready. Mrs. Mallory, you decided to go ahead with the shy.
That's good to hear, Mallory. From London, you'll drive to Froxfield. On the way, you'll be met at Boyton Gas Station. That's all.
I had hand carried this package all the way from Canada for him, and I've got to take a plane to Paris. Will you make sure that he gets that today?
Oh, yes, certainly,
okay.
Sir.
Okay. And can you give me a telephone number where I can reach him, because I'll phone him from the airport.
Oh, yes. The number is 435-9773, and the code from London is 03943.
Thank you very much.
All right.
I've been given a telephone number with a code 03943. Can you tell me where that is, please?
03943. Just
thank you.
Yes, that code's for Butley and Frost. Bromsfield in Suffolk.
Thank you.
A little late, Mr. Mallory.
Who are you?
Atkinson. Perfectly clean.
Sir.
It's perfectly clean, sir.
Where's Burbank? I said, where's Burbank?
Oh, I've been instructed to tell you you won't be seeing Mr. Burbank anymore.
Why not?
I believe he's retired. I think you need some petrol. We'll be instructed.
I'm coming to the conclusion that either I know the Shy or the Shy knows me. Who replaced Burbank?
Mr. Jeffries.
Who replaced him?
I have, of course. I believe we have something to discuss, don't we?
Go to hell.
Come on, Atkinson. Get into your car.
Can I ask how you knew?
It isn't a question of knowing. One, I never stopped. Sometimes I slow down, but I never stop. Two, it was an obvious setup. It looked wrong. And three, no, afraid of death, Atkinson? Do you ever think about it?
Well, no, not much.
Not ever, you mean? Must be under 33. A man told me once when I was in my mid-20s that you never really think about your own death until you're 33. Somewhere around your 33rd birthday, you start to think about it. From that point onwards, not a day goes by when it doesn't cross your mind at some point. Sure enough, when I got to be 33, I started thinking about it. And I've thought about it every day since then. I don't know whether what the man said to me was true, or whether the fact that he said it, like an astrologer's warning, stayed in my mind.
Tell me, why does the office call it a shy?
You're English, you ought to know that. English fairground. Throw a wooden ball at a coconut, it is called a coconut shy. Knock off the coconut, you win the doll.
Well, you'll get more than the doll when the time comes.
All I want is the doll, Atkinson. That's all I want. Just the doll. You wait here. When the office telephones, call me at this number.
Where is it?
You get word, you call me.
Sir. Excuse me, sir. May I tell you something that's been on my mind?
What is it?
Sorry about your wife.
I can't make up my mind about you, Atkinson. Remind me of a young man I killed on the night I first met my wife.
Well, you'll get her back, sir. I know you will.
You shouldn't say that. You don't know.
Good afternoon. My name is Mallory. May I speak with Mr. Deverell, please?
Mr. Deverell is not at home, sir.
Who is it, Adam?
It's a Mr. Mallory, madam.
Ask Mr. Mallory to come in, will you?
Would you come this way? May I take off?
I'm Jay Mallory, Mrs. Deverell. I've come to see your husband.
I'm Catherine Deverell.
How do you do?
Is it very important, Mr. Mallory? Is it business?
No, it's personal, Mrs. Deverell.
I'm just having tea. Will you join me?
Thank you. Will your husband be long?
I expect him shortly.
Very beautiful room.
It used to be a coach house. Those windows there and the ones facing were doors. Carriages used to drive right in and stop here. Of course, that was 500 years ago. The stone was brought from France by boat. In those days, it was easier by sea than by land.
What is that up there?
We've never really discovered. There is a ghost in this house. Sometimes a woman's face appears up there. It's just part of the mystery of this place. The past can be very mysterious. Are you interested in the past?
In a way, yes.
Have you known my husband long?
Be truthful, Mrs. Deverell, I have never met him. We have a friend in common with whom I have lost contact. And I was hoping that he might be able to help.
I see very little of him.
He spends a lot of time in Canada.
I know why you're here, Mr. Mallory.
I imagined you.
I haven't always been a jealous person. When I married Roland Deverell, I inherited the memory of his first wife. She was drowned, you know.
No, I didn't.
I didn't think I would be jealous of the dead. But there were other women, you see, who were very much alive. Even then, I wasn't really jealous. I was only jealous when my husband took just one woman. And I admit I was jealous.
How long have you known?
About a year.
How did you find out?
You must understand, Mr. Mallory. My husband, like so many very rich men, feel immune from other people's jealousies. He's not exactly blatant, but neither is he exactly secretive.
Where are they?
I don't know. Nothing like this has ever happened to you before, has it, Mr. Mallory? I can tell this has never happened to you before. Excuse me. Are you expecting a call, Mr. Mallory?
Yes, I told my office I would be here. Hello.
Sir, I've heard from the office. The name of the Shy is Deverell. Roland Deverell. Sir, are you there? Mr. Mallory?
Yes, I've got that. When and where?
Time, 1 a.m. Place, Butley Abbey.
Telephone number?
435-9773.
What was the number I wrote down on that paper napkin?
435-9773.
You're very young, Atkinson. You're probably even younger than my wife. How old are you? It would seem to be obvious that it is not safe for me to proceed with this. Will you get me clearance from the office? I'm leaving here now. I'll call you back. I have to leave. My office expects me on the 7:30 flight to Paris.
Do you want my husband to know you've been here?
Thank you for tea, Mrs. Deverell. Don't come to the door, I'll let myself.
get in touch with the office, Atkinson.
Yes, sir. You have full clearance to go ahead with the Shire.
Makes a difference, doesn't it? When the Shy knows he's going to be hit.
Shy?
You don't know who you've been working for all this time, Mallory?
Tell me.
How ungrateful. I was proud of you. You were my very best man.
I work for you.
Quite a coincidence, isn't it?
Where is she?
Mon mari, il a mis le café dans la tasse. Il a mis le lait dans la tasse à café.
I'd try to forget about her if I were you.
Dans le café au lait. Avec la petite cuillère.
Funny, isn't it? How all of you went to pieces in the end. Cheever, Burbank.
I'm not Cheever. I'm not Burbank.
You really thought you were going to pull it off, didn't you, Mallory? With my wife as the anonymous client. Oh, she's crazy. She's crazier than you are. She not only hires one of my own men to kill me, but she hires you, the jealous husband. Oh, well, at least she has a sense of humor. Which is more than I can say for you.
I'm not your wife's accomplice, Mr. Deverell. The office will tell you from the beginning I didn't want to take this assignment.
But you did, Mallory.
Yes, sir. But as soon as I discovered the Shy was yourself, I asked Atkinson to get me clearance from the office because I was in jeopardy of my wife's lover.
Yes. And I love her, Mallory. I love her. You never saw her. You never really knew her. She left you 2 years ago. She lived with you, yes. But she had left. Her departure last week was a mere formality.
No, I don't need her, sir. I just want to do my job.
You haven't got a gun, Mr. Mallory. So how can you have a job? It's funny. I've never shot an intruder. Or a jealous husband, for that matter.
Jealous husbands don't use guns, Mr. Deverell. They lack the personal touch.
Why did you leave me?
I found out about him and about you.
Planned to leave me like that? You planned to disappear?
When I found out you were working for him, I couldn't stand it. I wanted to kill him. You stopped loving him.
So you decided to come back to me?
I've always loved you. First and last.
And in between?
In between? There were others. Before you say how many, do you want to get your gun?
I don't have a gun anymore. I don't have any use for it.
Good.
Did you love him?
I did, once.
And then you found out that his wife had hired me to kill him?
She didn't hire you. I did.
You did?
I wanted to kill him, but I didn't have the courage. So I hired a professional. At arm's length. That's what you call it, isn't it? I called the office. Your office, his office. I want your best man. That's what your friend Burbank told me. Get the best man. I only wanted the best.
And that was it?
Of course. Always. How do you think I felt being married to you?
What do you think it's like to be married to you? No, I mean, what would have happened?
If he killed you? You're the best. He couldn't kill you.
But just suppose.
That was the arrangement, wasn't it?
What are you talking about?
Marriage. Till death us do part. Remember?
I remember. I remember someone wrote that death is a country without memory. Dead people cannot remember a goddamn thing.
We must live. We must go on living. You do still want me, don't you?
More than anything. For breakfast. Do 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 do
Thank you.